Hi, this is Anne-Marie Concepcion from InDesignSecrets.com. A lot of people ask me, where is the arrow tool in InDesign? I don't see it here at all. It's not hiding in some sort of pop-up menu. It doesn't appear anywhere up here. I made a dot there. Let me delete that. It doesn't appear in any of the menus. The answer is the arrow tools are hiding in the strokes panel. Actually, stroke panel. Doesn't that make a lot of sense? Well, kind of, when you realize that an arrowhead goes at the end of a stroke. So the first thing you need to do is make a stroke. And you do that with either the line tool or the pen tool. Let's start with the line tool. I'm just going to drag a line just like this, pointing at this guy. And what's happening? Oh, you can't see the line. Well, that's because when you make a stroke, you have to make sure in your swatches panel that the fill is none and the stroke, clicking on the stroke icon, is black. There we go. Now we can see it. You use the swatches panel to color the lines and the arrowheads because the arrowheads will be the same color as the lines. Now we go to the stroke panel, and here we can change things like the weight and so on. But what we want to do is come right down here to start and end. Let's start with a square and end with a curved arrowhead. Let me zoom in here with Command or Control Plus so you can see what I'm doing a little better. That's it. You can change the color of the stroke if you'd like. You can change the type of the stroke. We could make it thick, thin, for example, which doesn't look really great at 2 points, but maybe at 4 points, that looks kind of interesting. You can swap the starting and ending. So I can just click this little guy and it points the other way in case you dragged it in the wrong direction. I hope you didn't do that, did you? And finally, you have the scale tool down here. So let me go back to a normal solid line. And down here in the scale, like I think this box is a little big. So I'm going to scale it down. Let me try 10%. Well, maybe that was a little small. Okay, let's try 50%. Ah, that's much better. You can scale the start and the end separately in these two fields, or you can keep them the same by clicking this to link the start and end arrowhead scales. And that's about it. That's how you add arrows to the beginning or ending of any stroke that you create in InDesign. Hey, I hope you found this tip helpful. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles, to listen to our podcast, and to download a free sample issue of our monthly magazine called InDesign Magazine. Thanks for learning with us.